Hi everyone, welcome to HNS Physics. This is your Nasuma. Today in this class, I'm going to explain a linear magnification of lenses. So in the previous class, we studied a lens formula and sign convention of convex lens, contour lens. So based upon sign convention, today in this class, we have to discuss linear magnification of convex lens and contour lens. So here five subtopics are given. So first one is linear magnification. So we have to see the definition of linear magnification and general formula. Next, come to second one, linear magnification of convex lens. So linear magnification of convex lens, that magnification is positive or negative. So we have to see that value, and also we can write the magnification values for ray diagrams of convex lens. Next, third topic, linear magnification of concave lens. So that means that value is positive or negative, we have to see, and also linear magnification value we can write for ray diagrams of concave lens. Next, linear magnification in terms of U and F. So this relation is very important while doing the numerical problems based upon linear magnification. Next, linear magnification in terms of V and F. So we can write these two relations by using a lens formula. So these two relations are very important for 8th class to 12th class students, and also especially for 10th class it is very important. So that's why before start the class, all my dear students, watch complete video, and after watch the video, like, comment, share to your friends, and subscribe my channel. So let's start my year. First one, linear magnification. So linear magnification of the lens. So linear magnification is denoted by letter M. So how we can define that linear magnification is nothing but, so the ratio of size of the image to size of the object is called linear magnification. Size of the image to size of the object is called linear magnification, or we can define in other way. So that is, the ratio of image distance to object distance is called linear magnification. So first we'll discuss a definition. The ratio of size of the image to size of the image to image to size of the object, size of the object, object is called linear magnification. So it is denoted by M, right? So how we write? We can write the mathematical formula for linear magnification, that is height of the image by height of the object, or size of the image by size of the object. So this is called linear magnification formula, or we can write one more formula, that is M equal to image distance by object distance. The ratio of image distance to object distance is called linear magnification. So here very two important points. These two points are very important related to linear magnification. So right, when M is positive, means when M is positive or V is negative, V means your image distance, V is negative, Then the image is virtual, comma erect. So that means here, what is that point, man? Where magnification is positive. When the magnification is positive, our image distance is negative. So by the time that image is nothing but virtual image and erect image. Virtual means which image we cannot catch on screen, that image is nothing but virtual image. Erect means upright image. So when the magnification is positive or image distance is negative means that image is nothing but a virtual image or erect image. So this point is very very important. And see one more point here. When magnification is negative or V is positive, V is means image distance is positive, then the image is real comma inverted. That image is nothing but here real comma inverted. So that means here magnification is negative and image is positive, then the image is said to be real comma inverted. So real means which image we can catch on screen, that image is called a real image. Inverted image means, so this is the object, so this is the image inverted reversed. So this is nothing but these two points are very very important related to linear magnification. So what is the first point? When image is positive or image distance is negative, so then the image is nothing but virtual image, means that lens gives virtual image and erect image. When the magnification is negative and image distance is positive means that image is said to be real and inverted image, real image and inverted image. So these two points very very important related to linear magnification. Next to come to linear magnification of convex lens. Linear magnification of convex lens. So I'm taking here convex lens, right? This is the convex lens symbol, this is the optic center. So right, this is the f1 and 2f1, so f2 and 2f2. So already we discussed ray diagrams of convex lens. So listen more. For example, object is placed behind 2f2, right? Object is placed here. So then image is formed between the f1 and 2f1, right? Here image is formed. This is nothing but height of the object and this is nothing but height of the image, right? So this is the object distance from the lens and this is nothing but image distance. When means here convex lens gives a real image. In this case, right, we can write the magnification equal to height of the image by height of the object, right? But here height of the image is we have to take a negative sign, because below the principal axis, according to sign convention, below the principal axis distances are measured negative. So below the principal axis all vertical distances are measured negative. So here we have to take a negative sign. Next, Kanjara's equation. So that means what here? Magnification is negative for a convex lens for real image. Here magnification is negative for convex lens. This point is very very important. So for real image, already we discussed, when the magnification is negative, that image is nothing but real image and inverted image, right? Next, come to according to, if you write the magnification formula in terms of image distance and object distance, so you get here m equal to image distance by object distance, the ratio of image distance to object distance. So image distance is positive but object distance is negative, because the distance we are measuring opposite to the incident ray. So you'll get a negative sign. So right, finally this is the equation 2. From 1 and 2 we can write, from 1 and 2, right, height of the image by height of the object equal to image distance by object distance. Here is minus minus, so both side this minus will cancel. So finally you will get height of the image by height of the object is equal to V by U. So we can use, by using of this formula, we can find the, any three factors is given, we have to find the fourth factor. So for example, object distance, image distance and height of the object is given. Now by using of this formula, we can find the height of the image. So finally, we can give the conclusion for a sine convention, linear magnification of convex lens. So for real image, the magnification is negative. For real image, the magnification is negative. For a convex lens, magnification is negative for real image and positive for virtual image. Right? So when the object is placed between the optic center and the F2, image formed left side. So that time magnification is positive for virtual image. Right? So this is the sine convention, linear magnification of convex lens. So this formula is very, very important. By using of this formula, we can find any factor, fourth factor. If they will give three factors, means we can find the fourth factor. Right. Now we have to discuss linear magnification value for ray diagrams of convex lens. So these values are very, very important. So first one, when object is placed at infinity, u equal to at infinity. So image is formed v equal to at f, right side of the lens. That time image is formed at the focus, but the size of the image is less than of size of the object. So by the time the magnification value is less than of 1. So I am taking here magnitude, because sometimes magnification value is positive, sometimes it will be negative. That's why I am taking here magnitude. Right? So this time image size is nothing but a highly diminished. Next, come to right. Next one, second one, when the object is placed behind the 2f, that is u is greater than of 2f. So in this case, image is formed f is less than of v and v is less than of 2f. So that means here image is formed between the f1 and 2f1 at the right side of the lens. So in this case the size of the image is less than of size of the object. So size of the image is less than of size of the object. So the time magnification is less than of 1. So in this case, image is formed diminished, not highly diminished. Here highly diminished means very, very small size. Here just it is small size. Next, come to third one, u equal to 2f. So here object is placed at the 2f2 left side of the lens, that is uf. So here image also formed at the 2f right side of the lens. Here height of the image equal to height of the object, means size of the image equal to size of the object. So in this case, magnification equal to 1. So size, same size. The size is nothing but same size. Next, fourth one. Here, f is less than of u and u is less than of 2f. So that means your object is placed between the f2 and 2f2 of left side of the lens. So your image is formed greater than 2f. So that means image is formed behind the 2f1. So in this case, size of the image is greater than size of the object. Size of the image is greater than size of the object. So in this case, magnification is greater than 1. So that means your image is formed enlarged means big size. So the size of the image is greater than size of the object. Next, fifth one. So when object is placed at f, so image is formed at infinity. So in this case, size of the image is greater than size of the object. So your magnification also greater than 1. So that means your image is formed highly enlarged. That means that image size is greater than size of the object. Next, last one, when object is less than of object placed between the optic center and F2, right? In this case, image is formed same side. Image is formed same same side of the lens, same side of the lens at any place, same side of the lens. But here also height, size of the image is greater than size of the object, so here magnification is greater than 1, so that image is nothing but enlarged, right? So these are the magnification values for ray diagrams of convex lens. So these values are very very important, right? So next come to linear magnification of concave lens. We have to discuss linear magnification of concave lens. So I am taking here concave lens. This is the concave lens symbol, right? Optic center, right? This is the f1, this is the f2, and 2f1, this is the f1 and 2f1 and f2 2f2. For example, object is placed here. When the object is placed here, this is the incident ray. But after that ray is incident on concave lens, the ray diverges, but the diverging ray appears from principal focus, and one more ray is passing through optical center. So that means image is formed here. So this is nothing but here height of the object, height of the object. This is the height of the image. So here it is the object distance, this is the image distance. How we can define the linear magnification of concave lens here? The ratio of size of the image to size of the object. So that means size of the image by size of the object. So here size of the above the principal axis, object height and image height, these two values are there above the principal axis. So what are the above the principal axis? Those values are positive because those vertical distances are measured positive, right? Here magnification is positive for a concave lens. Magnification is positive for concave lens. This is a very very important point. Right, next to, if you write in terms of the magnification value, if you write in terms of image distance and object distance, so image distance by object distance, so that is image distance we can take negative, even object distance also negative, because these two are there same means we are measuring opposite to the incident ray, or these two are there on negative x axis, so those two values are positive, negative. So we consider as equation 1, these are 2. Now from 192 we can write, from 1 and 2, right? So height of the image by height of the object equal to minus v by minus v. So here minus minus cancel, then height of the image by height of the object equal to v by u. So by using of this formula, if you know the any three factors, we can find the fourth factor by using of this formula. So this is the linear magnification of concave lens. But here concave lens we have only two ray diagrams. So first, when object is placed at infinity and image is formed at f, so in this case height of the image is less than of height of the object, so that's why magnification value, so m value, that magnification value is less than of 1. So here image is formed highly diminished. So next case, when the object is placed wherever can place between the optic center and infinity, so in this case u equal to, for example I am taking any place O2 infinity, so image formed less than of f, so that image is formed less than of f, image distance is less than of focal length. So in this case height of the image is less than of height of the object, so that's why magnification is less than of 1. So in this case image is formed diminished. Your object is placed, optic center to infinity, wherever you can place optical center. So object is placed from optic center to between, object is placed between wherever can place that the image is formed of magnification value is less than 1, so that size is nothing but diminution. So this is the linear magnification of concave lens, and these are the values of ray diagrams of concave lens. Right, next concept is linear magnification in terms of U and F. So this relation is very very important for 8th class to 12th class students. So this relation, by using of this relation, we can solve the numerical problems. So very very important. So here, to take this relation, I'm going to take here one lens formula, 1 by F equal to 1 by V minus 1 by U. So here multiplying both sides by U, then we get so that is U by V minus U by U. Both side multiplying with U, right? Here U cancel, then U by F equal to U by V minus 1. So this minus 1 you can take a left side. So that is U by V equal to U by F plus 1, right? So U by V equal to, take LCM, U plus F by F. So generally magnification formula V by U, but here it is there U by V. So you can write reciprocal, that is V by U equal to F by U plus F. So V by U is nothing but magnification. So that is M equal to F by U plus F. So this is the relation, linear magnification in terms of U and F. So this formula is very very important for numerical problems. Last topic, so that is linear magnification in terms of V and F. So this formula also very very important. So to take that relation, again I am taking a lens formula. So that is 1 by F equal to 1 by V minus 1 by U. So again multiplying both sides by V, then we get right, both side you can multiply with V, right? Here V by F equal to V by V minus V by U, right? Here V cancel, then V by F equal to 1 minus V by U. So here this term you can take a left side, and this one you can take a right side. So then V by U equal to 1 minus V by F, right? Then V by U equal to, take LCM, so that is F minus V by F, but V by U is nothing but your magnification, so that is F minus V by F. So it is the relation between the linear magnification or linear magnification in terms of V and F. So this formula is very very important. So this class is very very important class. All my dear students, watch complete video. After watch the video, like, comment and share to your friends. Subscribe my channel. Thank you for everyone.